When it came 1989, the evictions were horrible. Then the Catholic missionaries, they saw that there was no other way, with the exception of bringing the idea of getting experience how to solve the squatters problem. This made Jane Weru of Kituo cha Sheria, by then Legal Center, came up with the idea of forming a Federation for the Poor People, which was Muungano Wanavijiji. We were taken round for various capacity building forums. This capacity building, they were being organized by Muungano Wanavijiji. The kind of training which were being taken, because slum dwellers, most of them have never been moving to slum to slum. By then we were still having old constitution. So this old constitution did not open way for us to know what is happening within the next slum. So through Muungano Wanavijiji and Akiba Mashinani, they started taking us to various forums, capacity building forums within the Catholic setups. Catholic missionaries, mostly the schools which are within the slums, they are being sponsored by the Catholic. And the Catholic, they were very much worried about the children who are in the slum areas, because most of the schools here, they were being built by the Catholic, and they were worried. When the eviction comes, then the children are going to be mostly affected. We started with exchange programs from slum to slum. Also, we were being taken to various workshops. The facilities which were by then which could accommodate our forums, either workshops, were Catholic churches, because in slums nobody was allowed to build a bigger house which can accommodate very many people. They tried to bring various organizations who are coming to sensitize us from where we are, so that are helping us through capacity buildings. Out of these capacity buildings, the community came to realize that there is a need to have a saving and crediting program which could provide the community with the experience of saving, because the economic capacity was very lower in the community level. Out of this awareness, we expressed our views, we chatted way forward. Jane Weru managed to go to India. She went to other countries which are having similar problems. Then she managed to make an appointment for the elders who are here to enable to go outside Kenya and learn the experience, exchange program, and to bring the experience back at home. So I, Evans Omondi Papa, there was Mr. Moniu, there was Nduta Salome, there was Ezekiel Rema, and there was a certain Muslim lady from Mombasa, because the Mombasa also, they had these similar problems of forced evictions. We went to South Africa. The experience, we went around the slums in South Africa, and the experience which we got there, mostly it was advocacy, because by then Muungano was looking way forward for those elders taken there to learn the experience, because the South Africans already, they had gone to India and learned the experience the Indians were facing. The experience which we learned from South Africa, it was advocacy. The advocacy was very much advanced than us. The other thing, The South Africa, we learned from South Africa, is saving and crediting scheme, which we came, and also the other thing, which we learned from South Africa, exchange program. We thought that the exchange could only take place from far country, foreign country, but we realized that the South Africans taught us very much about exchange programs within our neighboring slums to expand how to be strong about forced eviction and also to rebel, to fight back this eviction. When they taught us, if you don't fight back, those people are evicting you, they will just remove you. We managed to have outreaching programs to various slums surrounding us, various slums within Nairobi, and also within Kenya.